Today, I'm going to walk you through how to create a custom homepage in WordPress. And this is something that I'm having to do this weekend as well. So I thought that would be perfect to share with you. If you're like most people, when you first start your WordPress website, it often shows just the latest blog posts on the homepage, which is what I've had for the last 3.5 years, which has been fine too, because I've just been worried and concentrating on creating content for my audience. But now I want to showcase some of my most popular posts. I want to showcase maybe my most popular categories. I want to showcase what they call a hero section of why they should trust me. When people come into my homepage, they don't really know what to do with my website. So I want to kind of guide them through that. If you're in that same category, then this tutorial is for you as well. So this is kind of what the homepage of my website looks like. It's just showing the most recent blog post. We're going to go in and fix that. This is somewhat reliant on each theme. But the way that I'm going to show this to you, you won't need to worry about what theme you're using because we'll be using a plugin. So let me log into my dashboard. We're going to use SeedProd, which there is a free version if you wanted to use that, but I want to show you all of the power that SeedProd can do. So we'll be using the pro version. If you want to do that as well, you'll want to go to SeedProd and sign up for an account. Once you get signed up, you can go to downloads to download the plugin. You also want to make sure you copy your license key as well while we're here. And we can head back over to our WordPress dashboard. We'll go to plugins, add new, and we're going to upload a plugin. You can either choose file and find where it's at. Because I have it down here, I'm going to left click, drag it up and install now. Once it's installed, we'll also want to activate the plugin as well. And I'm going to go ahead and close this out since I've already used it. Now we see that SeedProd is here. We want to come over to SeedProd on the left. And let's go to settings so we can add our license key. You can paste in your license key and then check it. I've already installed it, so it already showcases that I have my license key here. Once you've added your license key, then you should be good to go. And then we can come over here to landing pages. This is where we will create our home page, which is also a landing page. For this one, let's do add new landing page. And then these are all of the templates that come with it. You can see that you can go into maintenance mode, 404, sales, webinar, squeeze, thank you. You can just go through here and find the one that is closest to you, or you could even start from a blank template. I like to save a little bit of time by choosing one that then I can adjust. What's cool also is you can also type in the one that you want to work on. So we'll use this one. You can click on the check mark. You can also preview it if you want to see it a little bit more. But this is the one that I want for my homepage. So we can click check mark, and then you want to give it a name. And the best part about this is I can customize absolutely everything about this. So you see, as I'm going through the page, you see different colors. These are the areas that you can adjust. So we have section area, we have a block area, and you keep on scrolling and you have all of these areas that you can make changes. You just want to go through here and customize it to you. One of the first things I want to do is I actually want to create an area so I can have a header up here at the top and my menu area. So we'll do that. And when we're looking at all of this, we can see on the left all of these blocks that we can choose from. And we also have sections. So these are perfect for like adding a header, which is exactly what I want to do. So I'm going to come under header and let's see which ones they have. These are the different ones to choose from. I kind of like the idea of my logo on the left and my menu and then a call to action. I'm going to choose this one. And it drops it down all the way at the bottom, but I actually want to bring this up. So what I'm going to do is get on the purple and move it. So I'm going to take it all the way up to the top. And now we can adjust this. So now we have the little image areas and the block sections that we can adjust here as well. So I'm going to click on my logo, click on the block settings. You see, we have an image here. Cool thing about this is we can delete this. If you have a logo, you'll definitely want to use your logo. If you don't, and you just want to have a placeholder, then once you delete this, you can use stock image. Let's see what comes up here. So you can use something like this as a stock image. They have millions of stock images for you to choose from. Since this is a logo, we actually want to use an actual logo, maybe your own. And I'm just going to pull something in that I have here and we'll select that as my demo store. And this is pulling in, once I click on this is pulling in a WordPress menu. So this is a menu that I already had and it's bringing this in from WordPress. So if you wanted to change that, then you can make it a simple menu. So you just put in the links here. Or what I like to do is just bring in a menu from my actual site on the menu screen. So this is pulling in here, and I like that. And then if you have a call to action, then you can choose this here. You can go to templates. Since this is a button, these are all the templates that you can choose from. You can even do advanced. So if you wanted to change the color here, you could change that here. But I like that I have a menu at the top. I'm going to make that just a little bit smaller so this isn't as big. You can make adjustments all the way through. So now we have our whole menu at the top. I like that. If you wanted to go through and change like the background of this, you can here. And because I don't like that, we can actually come down here and undo. So let's just undo that. And you can also redo or undo. You also have history. So if there was a few things back before that you wanted, you can look at the revision history once you click save. But because I'm happy with making that change, I'm good with that. And don't forget, you can go in and save often, which I always recommend doing. Now scrolling down, I'm okay with all of that. I like this area and I like these items that we're showcasing, but I want to bring in a little bit of social proof. I want to bring in a column. Then I want to bring in social profile. So I'm going to left click and drag this over. And these are the ones that I want. I can go in and click on it so I can change the URL structure for our social profiles. And I want to put those there. And I want to do that all throughout. I can also choose to make these large, medium. Where do I want to align them? I like in the middle, so we'll keep that there. Now the color scheme, if there's something that you want to change, we can actually go in and change the full color scheme. If you come down here at the cogwheel, these are global settings. So from here, this is where you can change the fonts completely. These are the ones that are automatically chosen. Calistoga, but if you want to do something like Bungie Shade, or and then pick the one that you want and then change the text as well. That's a little bit different. And the text will be this text that's on the body font. Again, if you don't like what you've done, you can make undos until you get back to what you wanted. The other cool thing is here we have the color scheme of this whole page. So you can change this to the palette of the rest of your website. You can choose color palettes here, and that will automatically come in to your site. You see it's changed up here, changed the links, changed down here as well. You can go through the color palette and pick one that works best for your site. That might be a little bit better. It's a little bit cleaner. Or if you know the color scheme that you want, you can simply go in and edit each one individually. So you just want to go through here and change out everything that is specific to your website and make it more about your website. The other cool thing is, like, one of the other things I wanted was I wanted to add a custom email signup form for my newsletter, and we have one here. If you don't have one here, you can go back to the blog section, and from the blog section, you can search for opt-in form. You can also start typing it in to find it, and then you can left click and drag it over until you find it in here, and then you can adjust it. Since we already have it from the template, I'm going to go ahead and delete this. And then what cPrider will do is it'll go out and it'll actually connect. You can connect to your email service provider. I'll show you how to do that under connect. We need to pick our service provider, and then you can connect it, go through the process of connecting it. And if you don't see your email service provider, no worries, you can actually connect it using Zapier. They connect with Zapier, and you can connect that there. Then once you connect that, then the opt-in form here will connect with your email service provider, and you can start collecting emails for your website. Okay, now that you've gone in, you've adjusted everything, you've changed out everything, you make your homepage look and feel like you want it for your website, we can go up here and click save. And then the final thing we need to do is go to page settings, and this is where you can make any final changes that you want. Homepage, you can change that name to whatever you want. But from here, this is where you want to take it from draft to publish. So let's go ahead and click on publish so that it is live for our site. And then one final thing we need to do is we need to set that up in WordPress to make this our home page. So I'm going to close out of cProd. And just to show you that, I'm going to open up my WordPress site. You see this is still showing my home page, which is the latest blog post. And so the final thing we need to do is go into settings. We'll go to reading. And from here, we have this area where your home page displays. We want to change this to a static page. And from the homepage, these are all of the pages that you have on your site. These are all the page names. Homepage was what we were working on. So I'm going to choose that as my static homepage. And if you have a blog, I have a blog, so I still want people to read my blog. So you want to pick the page that all of your blog posts will be on. I have named it blog, and then we can save changes. And now when we go to our site and when I click refresh, now this is my new homepage, which is wonderful. And then when I go to my blog, then this is my blog page. So perfect way to what I want it to look like. I wanted a new homepage and I wanted to customize it, and SeedProd made it super easy. And then if you wanted to create a whole landing page, say a sales page or a thank you page or something like that, then you can watch this video next as I walk you through step by step on how to create a landing page for your website. And I'll see you over there.